I've got some jobs that need doing. What do you say, Captain?
Mission Control, prepare for the entry crane release, Space 1 and 3.
Let's find you a job, eh? Let's see what kind of jobs we can find.
Well, I guess that was a crash of some sort.
watch it.
Jump.
Let's jump.
Captain, we need to turn this around.
Punch it.
The situation's not looking good, Captain. Stand down from condition one.
Hi, how are you? That wasn't a very good game for me, as you could probably tell. I wasn't really working as a team. I got into it at the end there, though.
Let's see what's out there.
Yeah, if you've not seen it before, it's essentially kind of World of Tanks, if you've ever heard of that, but with spaceships. It's interesting because you've got kind of, well, you have obviously vertical movement as well as the horizontal, so you can go underneath objects and things like that, but it's interesting. It's probably not something I'll play that often, but it's good for something different. It'll be a free-to-play game, kind of like World of Tanks is, but they'll obviously monetize it somehow. Not really sure how yet. I got into the closed beta because there's kind of founders packs that you can get into that give you access to more things, and I just bought one of those, which gave me access. No, it's nothing like it at all, really. First, Rogue System is first person, realistic physics. This is neither of those, really. Having a really hard time actually finding target.
We're taking them down, ship by ship.
Is that a better level?
Jump's not yet ready, Captain.
Okay. Well, Rogue System's first person, realistic physics. This is neither of those. It's it's obviously third person, very simplistic. You're basically a flying gun, so it's quite a lot different, really.
Captain. Done and done.
Yay. Worked together a little bit on that one. Thought about what I was doing a bit more and managed to win. Still only credited with 2 kills and 1 assist though, but I feel like I did more than that. Maybe the count isn't right or something. That's my excuse anyway.
Captain, I've got something new for you. Officer briefings. Come visit the market to get them.
Hi, Black Death, how are you doing?
Seems the right place to be if you're looking for a job.
I'm not sure which USB device it is that keeps going off and on, by the way, but I can hear it, but I just don't know which one it is. This looks like a team of 4 versus 5, so that's usually never fun. Yeah, I know how that feels. My reason for doing this streaming thing now is because I work from home, so we've got a fifth person. My wife actually suggested that I try to do something social, even if I'm not kind of getting out of the house, and this is my kind of way of doing that, and we'll see what happens. I generally do play kind of a few games to kind of escape from work a little bit, so I figured I would do that in kind of a more social environment.
Good hunting, Captain.
Reloading. overheating. Put the energy system offline. Multiple impact. Damage control teams on station.
Launching torpedoes. Goliath locked on. Let them have it. Let's jump. Goliath standing by. Warheads lap on our position.
I don't actually do that anymore. That's Chris Elliott's problem.
Enemy warheads lap on our position. I launch torpedoes. Scratch another enemy. Scratch one dreadnought.
We're taking them down, ship by ship.
Yeah, it's just really time-consuming. That's the only, you know, kind of downside with actually interacting with your customers. It's it just takes a really long time to reply to everyone, and especially things like Chris is dealing with the Steam release. It's like I think there's a few people that are just asking questions just to be difficult. And you know, before we went out, we thought that pretty much everything was in a Steam Q&A already before we even posted anything, but I guess not.
Fusion reactor is overheating. Put the energy system offline.
Goliath locked. Torpedo lock. Our Goliath has a lock. Launching torpedoes.
Destroyed. Nothing but a pile of slag. Goliath locked on. Let him have it. Punch it.
Yeah, I mean, I personally think it's a better system in, you know, like 95% of cases. and pretty much every single thing that someone has been concerned about, you can actually do on Steam. You know, they just haven't put any research into it before they get all angry and everything. Yeah, I used to be the same way. Ten years ago, it was the wrong decision to put something straight onto Steam and only onto Steam. These days, it's probably the right choice. It's a decent platform now. And as a developer, to be developing two different ways to do the same thing doesn't really make an awful lot of sense, especially when you're a small team like we are. Got him.
Thank you.
Just one more kill. Damn, I thought I would have taken him out as well.
Done and done.
There we go. 2 wins out of 3 so far. Yeah, I mean, I was anti-steam for a while, but I adopted pretty early. I think I got one of the Total War franchise games that was... it was basically a Steam installer in the on the DVD, and basically that was it. I had no choice if I wanted to play the game that I'd just bought. Similar to with World of Tanks, there are some other ships. These are ones that I got because of the pack that I purchased. And there are various other kind of ships and hero ships and things. And you can change the add-ons that you have. You have to unlock them at certain levels of experience and stuff like that. And obviously, you know, what you find works best for you. I'm pretty early in the game though. I'm at rank 6. And if you look at the progression here, that's pretty much nowhere, because I think it kind of, each gap between each level kind of exponentially grows. No, it's not made by the World of Tank guys. I think this is just released. Maybe they got the idea from that and kind of, you know, did a clone, but based it where they wanted to base it. But no, I don't think it's by them. I don't think it's even connected to them. It's just so similar to me as a person that doesn't play either very much that that's how I describe it.
I've got some jobs that need doing. What do you say, Captain?
Yeah, I mean, this isn't something that I can play every day. It's too monotonous for me. I guess I would play it if I was in the same mood as... I would play Grand Theft Auto or something like that if I was in the same mood as this, where I just want to kind of blast things.
Seems the right place to be if you're looking for a job.
It's so weird how the matchmaking works there. Sometimes it seems to kind of lose you as it's counting the clock, and you could see there it got to over a minute, and if you cancel it and then restart it, you normally get straight in a game. It's very strange. A lot of other people change ships based on what they see other players on their team have, because you've probably seen little ships that fire out kind of a green beam towards other ships. Well, those are healer ships, and it's useful if you're a big ship to have a small guy healing you as you go into battle. But I basically haven't played the game enough to have enough experience even in this one ship, so I don't really switch yet. I don't even feel like I have a total grasp for the controls yet.
stations, action stations. Set condition one throughout the ship.
Damn, that was my nuclear warhead that just impacted the wall in front of me. That was a really long kind of tit for tat kind of battle there.
overheating. Put the energy system offline.
See, I'm kind of getting done with this game already. Maybe 3 matches is my limit. If I can, each time I die, I normally try to launch my nuclear weapon, which they call Goliath, and try to watch it explode and see if I can take him out when I die.
Torpedo tube. Got to reload. Stand by.
The ship is damaged, Captain.
The ship's falling to pieces. We can't hold it again.
Are you full time with those guys? Guys are kicking our ass. Really good players. I think that's it.
Sound the retreat.
Yep.
This is a lost cause.
Not sure if you like saw on Twitter or anything, but I made these like backgrounds for when I'm doing other things. Oops. Let's see. Yeah. Okay. I'm gonna try to on the small screen. I'm gonna try to do things like showing my controllers or whatever, and then on the big screen, showing the actual game footage. If I'm doing, you know, something where I don't have a controller set up, then I'll just obviously show the game full screen. And I've ordered like a webcam that I might put myself on screen. I'm not sure yet. It depends whether people start acting like idiots or anything, if I actually get any viewers. But yeah, I mean, I've put some thought into this, and you know, made a logo that's kind of a parody of the Twitch logo. So, yeah, I think it should be interesting to see how things go. I actually quite like watching streamers and things during the daytime. It's some nice kind of background noise. Okay. Just thinking about switching game. Kind of done with Dreadnought. I'm probably going to stop the stream actually streaming so that Twitch will separate the broadcasts. I'm still in the chat though, so I'll still see what you're saying, and I'll reply either in there or when I launch whatever game I'm going to launch. So yeah, I'll be back in a moment with the stream.